Hey guys, it's me, Aqua, and welcome back to another episode of Aqua's Adventure. So today I've got a few things planned, and I'm sure we're gonna have a lot of fun. So, without further ado, let's get started. Okay guys, real quickly, I wrote down a bunch of things just to remind myself. I did redo the to-do list because we added like the pumpkin farm, melon farm, finding cats, stuff like that. So I think I got rid of a bunch. I added a couple things. If you guys follow the series, you might notice a couple things different, but yep. So I changed around quite a few things, so we can now remove that. There was a new snapshot released with like dual wielding, the new end and stuff, but sadly we are not updating because, partly because the snapshots are really unstable. I don't want to corrupt my world, crash my world, whatever, and because I don't want to reset my end. Or I don't know how it's going to work, because with the new snapshot, there's a new end. I just don't want to get confused with it. So we are not updating. We're going to update when the new update comes out, but right now we are not updating. Today we do have to add glowstone to the jungle farm. I did move all the cats to the bedroom, which you guys might have just saw right here. These are all the cats. Sadly, I had to kill a couple, but... So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So we have 11 at the moment. I had to kill a couple because I sat them down and then they kept moving even when they were sitting down, which was not natural, so kind of just got rid of them. But it's okay because we still have 11. And probably the biggest thing is I decorated the melon and pumpkin farm, so we'll go take a look at that. And also, let's grab some glowstone with us. And after we add the glowstone, we'll do some other things. And I have no glowstone. Are you serious? Okay, guys. So I have no glowstone, so we're actually not going to be doing that today. I thought I had some, but it is fine. But I do want to show you guys what I did with the melon and pumpkin farm. As you can see, it's quite different. The entire floor is made out of bricks. I added a fence all the way around. So it looks, in general, just a lot nicer all around. So now it's in kind of like its own little square instead of just being out in the middle of nowhere. The farm is working. Whoopsies. So the farm does have a little bit of issue because it does spew out melons practically everywhere. But I'm not too worried about it. This farm never said it was 100% efficient. But if we go down here, I even made this a little bit nicer. We do have melons coming in now. And I'm thinking we do lose quite a bit because there's... Oh, I keep falling. Like the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we are losing quite a bit, actually. Maybe I built it wrong. Who knows? If we come down here, we also got a couple pumpkins coming in. Did we lose any pumpkin? I don't think these even have grown. But yeah, I'm kind of... I wonder why this keeps breaking and stuff. But it is fine. I'm not going to worry about it too much. If we have to rebuild it, that is okay. Alright, guys. So there's two things that I want to do, and... The two things I'm really excited about coming up is I want to build all the cat houses, and I do want to go find an ocean temple or an ocean monument very, very soon, though we can't do both today. In this episode, we're going to be building the cat houses, and in the next episode, we'll be building the ocean monument. So now, we have to pick a spot and a place for the cats. Now, I still haven't even looked around myself. This is the first time I'm, like, kind of even looking. I know the dogs are right over here. Maybe we should put them by the cats also. Maybe we can build an extension out here. Maybe we can put them behind here. I honestly think putting them back here isn't a bad idea. I'm going to need to gather a lot of materials though. So, I'm going to go gather some materials. Alright guys, so I've got my wool and stone together. But one thing I just realized, I don't know what a cat house looks like. So together we're going to do a little bit of research. Now this is going to look very unprofessional, but let's actually go on the internet and let's type in cat house and let's see what a cat house looks like, because I personally do not know what a cat house looks like. Alright, so I can see that cat houses are kind of open. They have a lot of space. See, this intrigues me right here. Now, alright. Alright guys, so I got some more stuff together. I got some fences, torches, wool, stone, and I'm thinking the cat houses are going to be built out of wood. Now, they're not going to look like conventional houses like the doghouses, they're going to be a little bit weird. Now, they're mostly just going to be, like, how do I say this? Kind of levels of wood. So it's going to be things they can run and play and jump on, stuff like that. I might build them kind of like little shelters, but I don't know. Like I said, I don't want to build the same things for the cats than the dogs, because dogs and cats are different. I don't want them to have the exact same thing. One thing that is going to be different, though, is I don't have any more glowstone, sadly, so I'm going to have to go cheap on the cats. But yeah, I guess the cat shelter will start right here, and we can just kind of start digging. Now, I think the cat shelter is going to be a bit smaller, just because I can fit more than one cat in, like, kind of one home, in a way. So it's going to be a little bit smaller, and we'll actually just come up to the edges. And I've kind of been noticing that my world is really, really blocky. Like, I have just blocks of buildings. As you can see, this is a block, this is a block, this is a block. I'm about to make a block right here, but I like it. I like it when things are kind of more organized. Now, most of my world is actually pretty organized. The only thing that isn't is that roller coaster. This roller coaster is everywhere. That's the one reason, the roller coaster is one of my favorite and not favorite parts, because I love it because it's so cool. I mean, it took forever and I'm just proud of it, but also it's gigantic and it doesn't have, like, it's just everywhere. It's so random. That's the one reason I kind of don't like it, but it's fine. I'm not gonna worry about it too much. So let's get rid of the rest of this grass, and then I'll place some wool in. Okay, so all of the grass is gone. Now let's get some wool in our hotbar, and let's start placing some wool. Actually, this is a mistake. Stone is supposed to go here, and then we'll place some wool. Okay, guys, so we are almost done with the wool. There's just a couple more spots left, and I think I have more wool in my inventory. Let's hope I do, and alright, I just need to go get a little bit more wool, but that is not a problem. As you guys know, I did start breeding the sheep over here, mostly the sheep, just because I think the sheep are the most useful animal now since they drop food and wool. But of course, I did always bring a lot of wool with me because, yeah, if I'm going to farm sheep, I definitely want to get their wool. The only pain now is I'm going to have to go around the dogs, and I still have to name one of your guys' dogs, Everything Kids YouTube. I'm sorry that I still haven't named your dog. It's just, everyone's requests was, like, one dog, but yours is four dogs, so it's a lot harder, and I just kind of, like, I never took the time to expand it, but I will one day, and your sign will forever be there until I do. But let's quickly finish up the rest of this wool right here. And then we could place the fences. So let's place all these. Now, time for the fences. So let's grab the two stacks of fences and let's start placing them on the side. Now, we'll build fence gates later on, but for now, I'll just place fences. We'll just go right here. So let's break a hole over here. And so this is how much space we have for the cats. Let's quickly make ourselves a crafting table. Now what we can do is actually place this in the ground right here, because we will need that oftenly. So I think how you make one is just like this. Oh, of course it is. Perfect. Let's pick this back up. Now it is time to start the houses, but one more second before we do that. Let's just hop in here with our ender pearls. We're going to place some water bowls. Now, cats do not drink a lot. They're not very picky, I'm guessing, especially my cats because they're nicest. So I'm just going to place two water bowls in there. They are very dirty. They've got some dirt inside of them, but I will clean them after this episode. So they'll be fine with just two water bowls. Okay, so now, like I said, we just kind of have to build randomly. And what I'm thinking of actually doing is each cat is going to have maybe little mats. So each cat will have their own mat they have to stand on, and each mat will be a different color. I think that's how I'll do it, and then I'll build like a playground. So it's going to be a little different than the dogs. The dogs just have straight houses. These guys are just going to have mats, and they're going to be fun and wild. So we have a lot of white wool, which is very nice, on these fence posts. So I'm just going to kind of place them randomly. This will be fun, like little decorative torches. Hopefully this looks okay. If it doesn't, then I will go get some glowstone, but I'm just going to be honest, I'm not in the mood for going into the Nether. We went into the Nether a couple episodes ago to get a Wither Skull and some Blaze Powder. So I am not feeling going back in there. Alright, you know what? That looks fine. And we'll light up the middle later on. But let's make these little math things that I was talking about. So, each one will consist of... I think I should make 9. Okay, so the mats will be right here. So this will be one mat right here. This is going to be one cat's home right here. This color yet, so let's place some of this. Some yellow would do some good here. So far we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, so let's place another red right over here. We can place another blue right over here. So now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so let's make actually 2 more to make the perfect number of 11. So now what colors? We do need some pink. Where is my pink? Because we only have one other pink one. So the pink, we need more pink. All right, what color have we not used a lot? And the only color that we haven't used a lot is gray. That'll make the perfect amount. So each of these mats will represent a certain cat, and I will place signs and stuff for each of them. So yeah, guys, real quickly, what I'm gonna do is go get the names and stuff for each of them and name each mat, and then we will bring the cats over. Okay, guys, so I have written down all the names on a notepad right here. Let me actually expand this. So we should start making a couple mats. So Mr. and Mrs. Pineapple now. Of course, they're married, so we're going to have to put them on the same mat. And I think it's okay to put them on the first one right here. So right here, Mr. All right, guys, so all of the cats are named. Let's quickly enter Pearl over there. I'm going to totally miss. All right, close enough. So I did kind of make more mats than needed, so... like I said, even I think in the last episode, feel free to leave more suggestions, in today's episode. If I get more suggestions, I will name more cats. So the first one is Mr. and Mrs. Pineapple Bo Schmidt, then Emerald from Chloe Slack, Chubbs from Eric D, Odie from Nanogiz, Wilson from CapCTZ, Senpai from Fun with Emily, and... the last one here is Damon from Alleged Gamer. So we have 4 more spots, and if we need more, I'll even expand it. But yes, those are all the names. So let's actually bring the cats over and let them sit down and stuff. And yeah, I think we might actually have extra cats. And if we have extra cats, I guess they'll go unnamed for now. And they will get names when you guys suggest them. So let's... get all these guys to stand up. You will be him or her. Didn't look at the name. Let's see. Whoever doesn't have a name, you are standing on this mat. You will do this one. You are very close to this one. So sit down. You will be this one. Okay, who else does not have a name? I think we have 2 more people without a name. Stop pushing them off, you cats. Stop it. All right, well, you know what? Now, you were over here. That is not your name. And then, I guess you will be Senpai. Your name is now Senpai. And your name is now... what is your name? Go. All right, get back in your little mat. You get on your mat. I want to try to keep him in the middle. All right, guys. So, we have our names. We have 1 more cat, but it's not even named yet. So, it is fine. So real quickly, let's go through one more time and take a look at all your cats. So Bo Schmidt, these are your cats, Mr. and Mrs. Pineapple. We can kind of take a quick look. They all look the same. Maybe I should have got some different types of cats, but whatever. This is Emerald. This is Chubbs. And if you guys haven't noticed, Odie is the cat's name. And then the bottom name is who named it. So this is Odie. This is Wilson. This is Senpai. This is a no-name, this is a no-name, this is a no-name, and we got Damon. So guys, we have 3 with no names. Feel free to suggest the names. I will be more than happy to name them. Of course, I don't want to leave them unnamed, so... yep, suggest your cat names in the comments below. Or you can tell me on any social media platforms. Okay, now it is time to actually build that like kind of like playground housey kind of thing. So I have no idea how this is gonna work, but I guess we'll just go on it step by step. Let's place this right here just for now, so we know what where everything is. Let's build some stairs first of all. Some stairs would be nice. Let us build some slabs. So these will be a couple slabs. And yeah, these will be the big poles. This will be the actual wood. These will be the slabs, and that'll be the stairs. Alright, so let's see what my little brain can think of. So maybe this is gonna be the beginning of the playground, so they can kind of just climb up like so. And I probably should have brought an axe with me, but that is fine. I'm not too worried. Okay, so they will go up, and they'll have, a little bit of room over here. Now, this is going to be an actual kind of like little balcony room. So if we go up here, they can, this is going to be a little, oh, what'd I just do? Maybe I should have brought an axe with me. You know what? I'm going to go get my axe. Alright, so I went to grab my axe real quick, so let's chop this down, and we actually will need one more layer onto here. So we do have plenty of space, we should probably use most of it. So this will be a little balcony here, this is going to go too high. Let's get, come on, place one here. Well, this is going to get removed right here, because I want to place this right here. Now, all this inner space will have this right here. Like so. Alright, so this is going to be like our little hut. Let's see what this looks like from the outside. Alright, so that'll be the first little place. So right here, let's actually get rid of this. Let's kind of crouch a little bit. Do this and go one more out, and we will go even higher. Okay, let's see. From here, I think stairs should be used. Okay, so let's break the stuff under here. That will go up to a different level right there. So let's kind of go through here. Now, under here actually should be some tunnels. So let's build maybe a little tunnel. Okay, right here. This will be a little tunnel that they can kind of just run through and they can hide in. Forgot I can't crouch very well under here. Alright, so this will be one little tunnel, and they can hide or do whatever in here. Okay, I gotta place them in here. Perfect. Okay, so I also blocked up right here so they can't go into that, but this will be the little tunnel they can go through. Now, what else can we add? Yeah, I gotta kind of be creative here. Alright, well, while I'm thinking of stuff, we should add another little platform right here. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4 out. And add 1, 2, 3, 4, and add 1, 2 here. And actually, I did run out, so quickly we'll just be one big platform. Okay, and I'm gonna actually need to make more slabs, so let's maybe grab 1/4 of these, make them into more slabs. So let's add all these together. All right, that looks a bit weird. But we can maybe add, you know what? Okay, how is this gonna look? This is starting to look a bit weird. Okay, I think that's actually gonna work. Just kind of like a different kind of stairway, just to add a little bit of weirdness. Like I said, I want this to be kind of weird looking, you know? It's a cat house. It's supposed to be like really, really random, and yeah, so I want it to look a little bit weird. So if that's the second platform, what other things can we add? I mean, of course, we need kind of more tunnels, and we need stuff like scratching posts. So, you know what? Let's do something. Let's grab one of these, and let's make some scratching posts. So, of course, cats like to scratch things and do all sorts of stuff. So let's make little scratching posts right here. Here they can come, and if they want, they can scratch these little thingies, and they can tear them up, do whatever they want with them. So those will be scratching posts. Let's see. Now here, will be, of course, cats don't like water most of the time. They usually try to stay away from water. But I will put a little pool here. Now, I'm gonna refrain from using actual water because they oftentimes jump in water and die. So what I'm gonna use is blue wool, and I have that on me very, very conveniently. So let's place this down here. So this is gonna be their little pool if they so wish to get in here. Now, what else can we add? Maybe we can add just like a little pile of things they can climb on, so they can climb on top of that. Let's see. What else can we add? All right, so we'll kind of add something that we did with the dogs also, just kind of like a little thing they can climb up and down on. It'll be a little bit more straight, and they can climb above it. They can do whatever they want. We can actually connect it to this also. There's another way to get back up there. Now, what else can we do? Another fun thing we can actually do is we can make a little underground tunnel. So, where can we do the little underground tunnel? We can actually do it right here. We can go underground, which will be fun. Actually, we should probably back it up just one more and do it from here. So, how far underground? Okay, I think they'll go just about right here. Now, the other side will be right over here. So, let's remove all this. I probably should have brought a pair of shears with me, but oh well, it's fine now. So let's break all this. So let's grab more of our, we'll use light gray wool for this one because, of course, you know what? No, it's fine. I was about to say because I don't want to get stuck, but it's okay. It's not that big of a deal. But I will. I need to break it once again because I do need to do the little walls here. Hopefully we can break all of these, and then this place will put white wool here. So yep, they can go underground now. Well, I'm kind of really kind of out of ideas, but we did put the mats all their names, and they can go underground. They can go above ground. They can go up here. They can jump off into their pool. They have scratching posts. They have a little mountain they can climb. They have tunnels. I don't know why that's there. Okay, guys, so we are almost done. I'm gonna add one more thing, and that is, of course, cats love to kind of hit things and scratch things, so I will add one more up here. I will add something that kind of dangles, and they can try to jump up and hit it and scratch it and stuff, like a little mouse dangling. So that will be their little plaything. I mean, honestly, I think this is pretty good. This is a cat's dream. They have a swimming pool. They have scratching posts. They have like a hanging mouse they can try to get. They have a mountain. They have underground. They have a lot of things to climb and go under and hide. So you know what, guys? I'm pretty happy with this. I'm not gonna lie. That looks a little bit weird, but cat houses are supposed to look weird. So let's grab our ender pearls and let's try to look at it from a distance. How does this look from a distance? Honestly, it doesn't look terrible, I guess. Let's jump up on top of our roof. I have no idea if that'll hit our roof, but hopefully it does. Bam, right on our roof. Perfect. So there's our cats, and that does look a bit weird, but it is okay. Yep, it is okay. Now let's go back over here, make sure we don't have any crafting tables the cats can get themselves killed on. Nope. All right. Let's head back into our house. Alright, guys, so today's episode is gonna be over. In the next episode, we'll try to find an ocean monument, which I'm really excited for, because there's a lot of new blocks and stuff we can get. And if you guys can hear, there's an ice cream truck outside. That thing is really, really loud, but it is okay, I guess. So let's place all our stuff in here. And it's actually filled up that we do not need. That is fine. You know what? I need my sword. I'll take that. I'll take some ender pearls. I'll take that. And I will take some torches, and you can take that. Alrighty, guys, so today's episode is going to be over. Hopefully you guys like the little cat pen I built. It has all your guys' names, and like I said, once again, if you guys want to suggest names, leave them in the comments. I will use them. I still have three unnamed cats, and I don't want to leave them unnamed. So guys, if you enjoyed, make sure to leave a like and a comment as it supports my channel, and I'll see you guys later. God bless and goodbye.